when you walked into a meeting with Jeff Bezos, everyone who's worked with him will tell you this, there's an empty chair in the meeting. What does the empty chair symbolize? The empty chair symbolizes the most important voice in the room, the person who is not there, and that's the customer. Wow. What would the customer think of your idea, Eric? How would that idea simplify their life? How would it make them better?
Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Eric Corum, founder of AIM7. Welcome back to The Blueprint, where we distill cutting-edge science, leadership, and life skills into simple tactics optimized for your busy lifestyle and goals. Today, I am back with Harvard instructor and best-selling author Carmine Gallo, where he discusses the leadership secrets of Jeff Bezos. We're going to talk about why every organization needs a North Star and a compelling vision to improve motivation and cohesiveness. So let's dig right in. So let's lean in and learn from the best. Carmine, whether you're raising a family, you're leading a sports team, you're leading a business, team building is the key. What did you learn in writing and researching for the book, The Bezos Blueprint, about how Jeff Bezos built amazing teams? Because there is no doubt about it, Amazon's a behemoth, and it's not just because they have great tech. They built amazing teams at scale.
Well, it's amazing because I think a lot of people look at Amazon and they say, well, it's a 1.5 million employee company. What is there for me to learn about it, especially if you're a founder, entrepreneur, small business owner? People forget that Jeff Bezos started by himself. And then eventually when he opened or started Amazon, it was 10 people. So it did start as a small company. And he had to encourage stakeholders and investors and partners and employees to rally around a vision. So that's what I learned from Bezos and other exceptional leaders, that we all need a North Star. We all need a vision to shoot for, right, Eric? I mean, that's pretty obvious for anybody. You need purpose. Well, great leaders are very good at being the keepers of the vision, the repeater in chief. Let me give you an example. So go back to 1997. Jeff Bezos writes his very first shareholder letter, first letter as a publicly traded company. And he begins to outline the vision for what Amazon is going to be. Amazon, he says, intends to become Earth's most customer-centric company. So just think about that, Earth's most customer-centric company. Now, at the time, that was really important because people didn't even know what this internet thing was. Hey, you want them to put a credit card on it? So you had to establish trust, and he really had to make sure that everybody involved with building that company was aware that things had to be super simple, easy to use, and gave customers a sense of trust. So it would make sense that the vision was Earth's most customer-centric company. Your vision is going to be different, but here's the point that everyone can learn from. Jeff Bezos repeated that phrase in nearly every letter from 1997 to 2021 when he stepped down as CEO. One of the last words, last sentences in his last letter was, "We continue to be Earth's most customer-centric company." In every interview that I found going back to 1997 or so, we are Earth's most customer-centric company. And here's what it means. You see what's happening, Eric? Someone has to be the keeper of the vision. Otherwise, people are going to be taking, people will take their own initiatives, their own goals, and not have everything coordinated to the ultimate mission of the company or the brand. And what's fascinating, even to this day, when you see someone like Andy Jassy, who is the new CEO of Amazon, took over after Jeff Bezos, he is the one who really pioneered and ran AWS, the big cloud computing company. In his first interview, and I'm glad this happened before my book came out and before I finished writing it, in Andy Jassy's first interview, he said that consistent with our mission to be Earth's most customer-centric company, here are the steps that I'm taking as CEO. And I thought to myself, this sounds like the rest of the interview too. It sounds like Jeff Bezos. Jeff Bezos isn't there. How does he sound so much like Jeff Bezos? Because everyone internalized the vision and the values, but that has to come from somewhere. So that's why I recommend that leaders, you're the repeater in chief. You're the chief storytelling officer for your brand. Someone has to be the keeper of the vision and remind people of that vision constantly and consistently in all of your communication.
It also seems like if you're the repeater in chief, you should also be the hiring authority using that vision. So like if the vision of the company is, you know, to be the most customer-centric company in the world, you need to hire based off of that. And I'm thinking about times when I've been in successful sports franchises and times I've been in very unsuccessful franchises. And the senior exec or the head coach was more concerned about tactics than vision and mission.
Interesting. Yeah.
And that's when they failed, is they didn't have this vision and mission that everybody knew. It was just like, you know, we go out and execute these tactics. Well, you've got to orient people in the right direction all the time. And one of the failings in the NFL or even college football is you take people that were great coordinators, put them in a leadership role, and they fail because they're more focused on the tactics and the best, the Jobs, the Bezos, whatever. Yeah. They're thinking about the vision and the mission, and they're constantly espousing it. And that's what I'm hearing from you. And then you've got to use that. It's got to be how you hire, how you fire, how you grow the organization.
And if you're really advanced as a leader, use symbols. That's something else that I never really had the opportunity to write about in my previous books until I started researching Jeff Bezos. So first you have the vision, Earth's most customer-centric company. And if you go onto Amazon's website today, that's still the mission. So it's consistent since 1997. But here's the other thing. When you walked into a meeting with Jeff Bezos, everyone who's worked with him will tell you this, there's an empty chair in the meeting. What does the empty chair symbolize? The empty chair symbolizes the most important voice in the room, the person who is not there, and that's the customer. Wow. What would the customer think of your idea, Eric? How would that idea simplify their life? How would it make them better? Oh, how about one-click shopping where we remembered the customer's credit card? That was a big deal at the time. No one did that. So again, it's all of those things come back from or derive from the ultimate vision. So you're absolutely right. Whether it's a household CEO, whether it's a sports team, whether it's a startup or an organization or a department, someone has to be the keeper of the vision because people need to be led. I was told by a billionaire venture capitalist, John Doerr, one of the first investors in Amazon. He did pretty well with that investment. So John Doerr told me that anything worth achieving today is the result of a team, is teamwork. But teams need to be led. And that's why a team needs a storyteller in chief to lead the team and to rally everyone around a common goal, a common vision.
Yeah, I think we all like you want to become a master of your craft. And so you're like, I'm really good at this thing, but you forget the ultimate. And something I've been going back to, actually one of my Q2 OKRs was to continually repeat this to our team. So AIM7, my company, our mission is to empower people to live healthy and impactful lives. Because we believe if you're healthy, you can live a life of impact. And so yeah. It's really like, no, we're not helping you do your job at work or helping you be a better citizen in the community. But if you're healthy, guess what? You can go live a life of impact. And so that's something I've been repeating to myself, to our team in weekly standups. And I feel grateful now that there's a pattern because I was reading your book and I remember this stuff.
Excellent. So, do you know who invented OKRs?
Intel, right?
Right. Well, John Doerr. So it was originally from Andy Grove at Intel, the pioneer of Silicon Valley. And John Doerr took something he learned from Andy Grove and introduced it to another company that he had just invested in called Google. $11 billion. Yeah. But he pioneered OKRs and Google was an early adopter of that. But what is OKR? What's the first word mean? Objective and key results. Again, big picture, objective, ultimate mission and vision first, then how do we achieve it?
So it's like you're hearing the same thing over and over again. Yeah. And if you're not paying attention, you know, you're going to miss the forest of the trees. And so, like, you know, if you have something, whether it's your family, you know, and you want to lead your family, what's the vision of your family? What's the mission of your, I don't think most people think about, like, who are we as a family? Who are we as a community? Who are we as an organization? This is such a powerful, powerful concept that we should all put into place. I'm going to pump your book here, and this is a shameless plug, but I absolutely love this book, The Bezos Blueprint. My friend, I said before, Brian Decker recommended it. It did not disappoint. I read it very quickly. Highly, highly recommend you get a copy of this. And Carmine, thank you so much for joining me on The Blueprint. It has been a pleasure and a privilege to have you on the show.
Well, thank you so much. I'm learning a lot from you as well. So continued success with your podcast. You're doing terrific work. Thank you.
Thanks for joining me and Carmine today. And if you enjoyed today's episode, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. And if there's somebody that you want me to bring on or a subject you want me to get into, leave me a note in the comments. My job is to bring you actionable information that can help you look, feel, and perform better. And to do that, I need to hear from you. Thanks again for listening today, and I'll catch you on the next episode.